Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG with Bridgecom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to set up a Wi-Fi network on your SkyBridge using your computer. So this is a really simple process. So if you have your SkyBridge, you're using it, happy with it, but want to use it on a Wi-Fi network, we'll show you how. Now if you don't have a computer or you just want to be able to do it from your cell phone, we do have another video that will show you how to do that. So in this case, we have our SkyBridge plugged in, powered up, and we are connected to Ethernet. Now this is important that we make sure our computer we're going to be using is on the same Wi-Fi or network that this is actually plugged into. So assuming it is, what we're going to do is look on the SkyBridge here. We're looking for this number right here. That's the IP address, this 192.168.1.177. That number is going to be different for you. That's why we display it here on the screen. A lot of hotspots you have to go through digging through router information to try to find it, and this can change. So you want to look on the screen here. It will tell you what to do. So type that number into a web browser, and there we go. Type that number in, and just click enter. If our computer is on the same network, it's going to connect. There we go. Once you arrive at the dashboard, click on configuration. There we go. If it asks you for a username and password, the username is going to be pi-star, and then the password is raspberry, R-A-S-P-B-E-R-R-Y. So once you're there, go ahead and scroll down until you find Wi-Fi configuration down here, this wireless configuration. Click on configure Wi-Fi. Now you can see we already have one network in here. So to add a network, just go ahead and click add network. Now what I want to make note of here is if you're going to add a cell phone hotspot, like a wireless hotspot in your cell phone, if you intend to use this with your cell phone or whatever device you intend to use it with the most, I would recommend that being the first network. The reason being is when it looks for networks, it's going to prioritize the top one. So if you travel a lot with using your cell phone, I would recommend making that the first network, and then anything beyond there, secondary networks. So we already have our cell phone on here. So I'm going to add another network. Now, if you click add network, you can just simply type in the information. Now, if the network is hosted and is visible, you can do scan for networks. It'll take it a minute there. Awesome. There we go. And we can see there's the Bridgecom network. So you can just select it, and that's going to take care of the first part, the name. The SSID is also basically just the name of the network. And then you can go ahead and enter the password. Now the name and the password are case sensitive. Just keep that in mind. Awesome, there we go. Just hit save and connect after that. And then you should pretty much be good. I like to apply changes. We'll give it a second here. Awesome, there we go. So at this point, just go ahead, once this reboots here, click on power and just go ahead and reboot your SkyBridge. Sometimes you will have to reboot it to get that to actually connect up to the network. After that, you're all set.